Hello, it's July 2024 and Power BI just released their new update. Today, I'm going to talk you through the update, but I'm going to specifically call out four worthy updates. We're going to dive into it. There'll be a working session. You'll have everything you need to know to understand the Power BI July 2004 release. Let's look at that right now. So what we're going to talk about is their main focus of their update is on Azure Maps, and they've updated the functionality of reference layers. So we're going to do two things. I'm going to first talk through the update, but then we're going to do a lab tab. I have an example where I'll give you a GeoJSON file. You can actually load it into a reference layer and mirror and see this functionality in action. Secondly, from a general availability perspective, they released officially row-level security, a new user interface for it. It's been kind of out for a while, but now it's in GA. I'll give you a quick update on that one, show you how to do it as well. Also, there's some DAX query updates. I'm going to talk you through those. I'm going to do a working session. I'm going to show you how to go through and pull what they discuss in this update that's available. And finally, some more updates to the pbir functionality, and I'll talk about that too. So you're going to get a lot in this update. It's not the biggest Power BI update, but there's going to be four worthy updates. So let's dive into Power BI Desktop. Let's go. All right, so here we are in Power BI Desktop. This file is available for you to download. Go to the description of this YouTube video and click on the GitHub link. You can open this file up and follow along. There will be some lab tab items in here where you can actually build the map that we're going to go through, learn about these update hands-on style. So let's dive into it. Firstly, the update from Power BI for July just came out today, July 11th. Within it, they list out a varying number of things, but specifically, we're gonna focus today on the four most worthy updates. What those are gonna be, each one will correlate to a tab in this file. So you can click the tab and we'll talk through it as we go through each of these updates. You can see them in action, have some awesome examples for you, and we'll go through it together. So the biggest section of the update, always these updates, the reporting section and the modeling section are just the best. That's where the most user-friendly content is for us developers. So firstly, we're gonna talk through the Azure Maps visual. We already covered it in the intro, but then as well as RLS, DAX query, pbir formatting as well. You can see there's some other updates. You know, I don't need to talk through the connectors that are out there and that kind of thing. And I typically don't do the paid visualizations, where it's like a dollar per user to use these visuals. I stick with the core foundational Power BI Desktop stuff. So let's dive into it. Firstly, for the map, what's important to understand this big update is all about the reference layer for Azure Maps. And within that reference layer on the right-hand side now, you're gonna be able to control the polygons, the lines, and the points. Previously, you would have to do this in a GeoJSON file. So again, some of you aren't total map nerds yet, but if you want to get to that point, there's a link to a video I've created about how to master these Power BI Azure maps. Go ahead, click that and watch it and get up to speed. But specifically, I'm going to talk to you through now how these work for the reference layer. And we'll do that in a working session. Again, previously you could add reference layers, but you weren't able to control the formatting. So this is now available. And sometimes it's better to understand something by just doing it. So let's do it together. In the lab tab, again, you don't need to know too much about the data model that is here. I'll talk you through the key points of it. But what we're gonna focus on for this is for the store, every store has a latitude and a longitude. So first, just click those two things. It's gonna pull up a map. It defaults to not using the Azure map, which is not what we want to do. We always want to utilize the nice Azure map. So now click that sucker, we're in there. Let's also add from sales, the net sales amount to the size of these circles just to get a better gist. But what we can see, and again, there's so many different reference layers out there for different maps you're creating. And a reference layer, just think of it as something where you have your map, your key coordinates and your values, but then a reference layer just sits on top of it and it's another visual. But you used to have to control the formatting of it through code. Now you can control it here. So in the GitHub link as well, there's another file. I actually gave you a GeoJSON file. You can upload it, you can look at it, you can see how to work with it. But all you're gonna wanna do is go to File, Upload, and click Browse. It's going to go to the place wherever you downloaded it to. I'm just going there now, and I loaded it in. So now you can see it overlaid. This is called the Chicago neighborhoods. It's putting the borders around all the neighborhoods in Chicago. What we can do is now start getting in here, and let's change the border width up. Let's make that border color purple. Let's make the fill color a little light green. Light green doesn't look too good, maybe light purple. And you can get in there and just tweak it up as you like. So again, depending upon the GeoJSON file you load or any type of file, you might have the opportunity to control polygons, lines, or points. There's different things you can control. And this one, it's gonna be polygons. But there you go. So again, there's a lot to do in the map itself. Check out the video I've created that dives more into it. Because there's a ton. It's a really cool visual. Again, some things are quite simple. You want some traffic, boom, turn it on. It's updating traffic in real time. All kinds of neat things like that. Again, traffic control, incidents, what you want to see. I can get into it. All right, we're going to move on. So now the general availability of low-level security, the user interface. This is not something that is brand new. It was rolled out, just not in general availability in the past, but the goal of this is to cover the key updates. So firstly, if you know row-level security, it's essentially a way to protect your Power BI file by having people enter in or access it utilizing a credential if it's published in the Power BI service. To break that down in a simple way, in this example, if you want to create row-level security with me, let's do it. So let's say for the flat planes, we want to make something where if someone logs in and in Power BI service, I put them in the flat planes group. I only want them to see that. Well, you can now do that with this update without having to type any DAX. So simply go to manage roles. I'll make a new one. I'll rename it. I'll call it flat planes. And what I'm going to simply do is go to the part in the data model where that resides, pick the file itself, so stored region or the field, equals flat planes. And just like that, it's created this for you. In the back end, it used to look like this, where you'd have to type in DAX. And again, this is an easy one, but it can be trickier if you have more complicated low-level security. I'm gonna save that, hit close. You can test it then by going to view as and flat planes. There you go, now I can see it. One thing that I did add that can be quite valuable for you to check out is on the left-hand side, there's a matrix here to do this. I went through and created this new kind of real cool matrix where you stack multiple visuals on top of each other. It's a matrix with kind of bars popping out the summary for the rows and the columns. If you want to see that, check it out here. You can go look at that video. Let's keep moving forward. Okay, DAX query updates. Again, this has been around, but the functionality that's new is going to be key up here on the left-hand side. If you work with Power BI Enterprise, previously you were not able to utilize some of the functionality of DAX query view within a live connected data set, but now you can. And so what that looks like, I'll talk through both these kind of DAX query-ish updates, but firstly, there's another file or video you can watch that goes deep into how to leverage and use Copilot and DAX query view. Check out this video right here. What we're gonna do for this example is if we come into Copilot, I'll delete some of these things I've created. You'll see show column stats, show certain things. So pretend you just connected to a live model. And again, the way that you typically do that is you go to get data, Power BI semantic models, and you're connecting to something in your service. But then after that, you're kind of done. Maybe you're a report developer, you wanna know, I want to know more about this. I can't quite see all the behind the scenes, so how do I learn about it? Well, now that's what the whole point of this is. Because what you can do is if you go to DAX query view, on the right-hand side, you'll see your model. You can now click any table and say, I'll say quick queries, show me the top 100 rows. Well, that's no big deal. You can kind of do that over in this tab as well. Okay, cool. But now we can start to do, say you need to understand some statistical descriptions, kind of like a Python data frame description. Well, now you can go show column statistics. We can see that for the varying columns, the min, max, the unique number of values within them, the median values, the mean, the standard deviation, evens, odds, all these sorts of statistical things like that. You can now get it on the model. But even cooler, maybe you want to say, okay, I want to know every single measure in this thing. So you can just right click on it, queries, define all measures in this model, the whole entire model. Now that just came back right here. And so I can see all the logic behind all the measures where previously you're just not able to see that. What's cool as well that they call out in the update, specifically they call it out under this section where add or update multiple measures in DAX query view. Where now if you're back here, say open this up and I'm working on a model and I want to change multiple things. Well, now you have the update function in the top left here to update model with changes. You can see it says number 13. That means you can make multiple updates, click the button once, everything updates. That is very helpful when working on very large semantic models. And finally, the fourth most important kind of worthy update from this is that they've already made an enhancement to the pbir. And again, I'm going to create a video on this to really walk you through how to create a world-class source control system. But what that looks like is essentially the Power BI file itself will check into, you know, Git using VS Code or any kind of other tools. This diagram on the right-hand side kind of describes it. But the update for July is that on the left-hand side here, when it was released last month, it said you're going to be unable to use subscriptions, you're going to be unable to download it and do these varying things. Well, they came back in this July update and they kind of said that now you can do these things, where they worded it in like a double negative way, but it says can't be included in subscriptions, but up here they said this has been resolved. So some things you can do now is it can be included in subscriptions, it can be exported, mobile layouts are applied, and it can be used in Power BI embedded. The one key thing is that you're unable to publish the report in a Power BI app. So again, if you're not into the source control yet, you're not alone. Not many people are using source control at all right now. It's pretty darn new. So, but those are the big updates. Thank you for watching. After watching this now, you should have a full understanding for how to utilize all the new updates in the July 2024 release. Hit subscribe, like, leave a comment. I read everything, and I'll respond to you for sure. You all have a good day. Bye.